Hey everybody, thanks for joining us here at Micro Center, where we've got all the parts you need for your next project, from Arduino to Raspberry Pi and all of the components in between. Make sure to like and subscribe and share this with the community. We've got a huge launch today to announce, so let's head over to the studio and dive in. So at 9 a.m. in the UK, while we were all sleeping this morning, the Raspberry Pi Foundation announced the Raspberry Pi 4 Model B. This is an upgrade to their previous line, the 3B and 3B Plus. If you're not sure what a Raspberry Pi is, it's a single board computer that generally costs around $35 that can be plugged into things that interact with the outside world. Let's say you want to control a motor, or let's say you want to get temperature data from your refrigerator and you want to put that out on the internet. A Raspberry Pi computer is a great thing to be able to do that type of a project with. What's exciting about this launch is it's not just a board. It's a board and a number of official accessories, which up until this point, Raspberry Pi had not been producing en masse. When talking with the CEO, Eben Upton, and the Pi Foundation, they seemed very excited about the 4 gigabyte option as a potential to really let the Raspberry Pi stretch its legs in what it can do. Now with 4 gigabytes, you'll be able to do things like web browsing, checking email, and doing some basic 3D games, as well as learning to program at speeds that you weren't able to do before with the previous boards, the 3B Plus. This makes the Raspberry Pi a real contender for a desktop solution. We're really excited here at Micro Center to see what you, the maker, are going to create. We can't wait to see what you do in terms of gaming, what you do in terms of Internet of Things projects, or if you do start to use this as a desktop solution to check your email and browse the web. All right, let's dive right in and take a look at the differences between the Raspberry Pi 4 and the Raspberry Pi 3B Plus. With the Raspberry Pi 4, you're going to see that you still have your 40-pin GPIO so that you can interact with the outside world, doing things like controlling motors or taking temperature feeds. You're going to still have that same composite video and audio output to be able to plug into an old, let's say, tube television or CRT television. You're still going to have your same camera and display outputs, so the old touchscreen and the old version 2 camera are going to work with this board. We now have a USB-C port from the old micro B port, USB-C, which is capable of higher amperage. So at 3 amps now, we can now power a full gigabit Ethernet port. That's really exciting for people that are running Pi servers to be able to transfer data speeds higher than they've been before. What's very, very, very exciting about this board, which we haven't mentioned up until this point, is the dual output of micro HDMI. We used to have on the model 3B Plus just a single standard HDMI output. Up until this point, we haven't been able to run dual displays off of a Raspberry Pi. So what this is going to allow you to do with two outputs is do desktop applications that would run across two monitors. And the big benefit to these is now they're capable of running 4K. You can get 60 frames per second on a single channel, or if you're running two monitors, you can get up to 4K with 30 frames per second. On the front, you're also going to see that the USB ports and the Ethernet have switched around a little bit. Now, if you can see the blue on these middle ports, you probably know that that's USB 3.0, meaning that now we're actually going to get some higher speed transfers of data to and from our Raspberry Pi. This again is very exciting for those users that are looking to do servers that is copying data from the Ethernet to a USB drive or to an external hard drive. So with the addition of 3.0 and the power necessary to do gigabit Ethernet, true gigabit Ethernet, you now have the availability to process data a lot faster. And on the top of the board, you can see that the chips for the most part haven't changed. You still have your main processor here, which is a Broadcom. You still have your Wi-Fi and Bluetooth up here. The Wi-Fi is 2.4 and 5 gigahertz, as well as Bluetooth 5.0, which is an upgrade from the previous Bluetooth 4.2. We also still have Bluetooth Low Energy on this chip. Over here, you'll see the actual RAM module. So with the old Raspberry Pi Model 3B Plus, we had a 1.4 gigahertz quad-core processor. Now with the Raspberry Pi 4, we're getting a 1.5 gigahertz processor. While that may not seem like a big upgrade, the big news here is that we're now getting 3 variants of memory. So your old 3B Plus might have had 1 gigabyte of RAM. you now have the opportunity to stick with that 1 gigabyte, but also move up to a 2 gigabyte and a 4 gigabyte. You still have your power over Ethernet pins up here, allowing you to add an additional hat so that you can power and control your Raspberry Pi over just the Ethernet port without the need of a USB power supply. As with the previous model B+3, the SD card slot is still located on the back. As of right now, when this board launches, there will be a version of Noobs 3.1, which will include an installation for Raspbian 2. Now, with all of these modifications, with the new ports and with the shuffling around of old ports, what you might be thinking is, will my old case work? And most likely it won't, unless you have a very open case that stacks or that leaves access very widely on the side. You're not gonna be able to use your old case with this. I mean, maybe if you take a Dremel out and you start hacking away, you might get away with it, but we don't necessarily suggest that. Or do we, because they're makers? Maybe we do. But don't worry, here at Micro Center, we've got you and your Raspberry Pi covered. So we'll be bringing in the new official case as well as some other cases from manufacturers. But in the interim, to get you going, we're going to offer a link in the description below to a 3D printable case file so that you can put some protection on your Pi very quickly. Now that we've talked about the difference between the Raspberry Pi 4 and the 3B Plus, let's actually get the Pi 4 hooked up to two monitors. The first thing I'm gonna do is take my keyboard and mouse input from the official Raspberry Pi keyboard and mouse and plug it in to one of the USB 2.0 ports. The next thing I'm gonna do is take my first monitor and plug it into the HDMI 0 port on the right, and my second monitor to the HDMI 1 port on the left. I'm now ready to supply via USB-C the power necessary to get this guy running. Guys, this is pretty exciting. We just let the Pi 4 boot up and it is now on dual monitors. We've got two monitors here running a ton of programs for a Raspberry Pi. And I have to say, it's running very well. I'm able to type no problem. I'm able to move windows around without lag. The YouTube video is running very smoothly, so no issues there. And I've got a couple of tabs here. I've also got Micro Center's website up, showing all the best deals. Normally I wouldn't run this many programs on my computer at any given time, but it's really, really exciting to see that the Raspberry Pi Foundation put in the care and effort to provide a product and an operating system that can now really do some desktop style computing. If you guys are interested in trying out the Raspberry Pi 4 as a desktop solution for yourselves, make sure to keep your eyes out for the official Raspberry Pi 4 desktop kit. This will include everything you need, except for the monitors, to do a full dual monitor setup. Make sure to keep checking back to microcenter.com for all official Raspberry Pi accessories and all the maker goods that you need for your maker projects. If you guys are as excited as we are about this Raspberry Pi 4 launch, make sure to like and subscribe. And don't forget to share this content with your friends so that they're in the know as well about the brand new Raspberry Pi 4. We're really excited to see what you, the makers, are going to create with this. I'll be hanging out in the comments below, so make sure to add your questions and your thoughts and any project ideas you may have. Thanks for watching. We can't wait to see what you'll make.